Hey all, Dave here, and boy, do I love having meaning to my life. I like to keep mine on my desk so I can look at it every now and then. It's right. Oh no! I've lost it! My purpose in life is gone! I gotta go find it! My purpose in life is meant to give me a reason to do the things that I do. If I've lost my purpose in life, then how could I possibly justify eating food? I guess if I've lost mine, then I need to find some objects and interests that reflect my purpose in life. This might be a good place to start.
Purpose is a vital aspect to our humanity. Without it, it's safe to assume we'd be very little more than organically created androids, and even they need a purpose in life. Ultron lost his, and that caused him to try to wipe out the entire multiverse. To be clear, I don't believe that your purpose is meant to guide you in making every decision, or in doing everything you do, but it's more so a compass for you to glance down at occasionally when doing important things, like choosing a career or eating food.
What am I supposed to eat?
A lot of times, a person's purpose can be guessed quite accurately just by looking at their interests. Speaking of which, let's find out what's inside that box.
This is tech from the Bad Batch.
This is my PC, which I like to call the Ship of Theseus. I've personally installed and replaced nearly every piece of hardware inside of it. I mainly run Ubuntu, a form of Linux, as my main operating system, but I have taken the time to install Windows 11 on it for fun. Needless to say, messing around with this computer is my main hobby. It's just really fun for me to run commands in the terminal, or to learn how to use new programs that are useful to me. I definitely see this as a current passion of mine, but who knows, maybe in the near future it'll also become a vocation, profession, or even mission in my life.
When you see everything that I've done with my computer, you probably think that I've been interested in tech all my life. That's true, but I only built that computer 6 months ago. I believe that my interest in technology first started in late 2009, when I got the first result on Amazon for 2000's nostalgia.
Video games are another major passion of mine. I've been playing them for nearly all my life, and that all started when I got a Wii. This has definitely been a large factor to why I'm now so interested in technology as a whole. In fact, my interests in both of these things have overlapped for quite some time. I game on my computer a fair amount, but I guarantee you, these games would not run nearly as well as they do if it wasn't for me replacing the very outdated hardware with slightly less outdated hardware. As it turns out, one of the first items of tech I messed around with for fun was my Wii. Last year, I actually hacked into, or homebrewed, my Wii. Now, I can do so many things Nintendo doesn't approve of, like playing as Sonic in Mario Kart.
Now you see, the main issue that I found when pursuing tech and gaming as hobbies can be summarized by looking at my wallet. As you can see, I have about 25 cents. A new graphics card costs about 50.
Computer parts, especially in 2021, are expensive. This doesn't make it impossible for me to pursue this as a hobby, of course, but it certainly makes it much more difficult. A lot of times, I just need to make do with buying older computer parts. But there are some things you really shouldn't buy if it's old or used. Of course, this isn't a very big hindrance to following this as a meaning in life, but it is something I need to keep in mind, especially when I'm an adult. I guess that's what people were thinking when they said money is moderately important to me. Obviously, I will need to keep track of my income and expenses, but as long as I have a comfortable wage, I really don't care how much money I have in life. Honestly, that's about the only real obstacle I can think of that prevents me from pursuing my passions, and for that, I consider myself very lucky. Tech is definitely a big part of my life, but I think it's also important to take a look at one of my other passions in life.
That's right, Mr. Tech Support likes the great outdoors a lot.
I went backpacking this summer at Philmont, arguably the most famous scouting-related place, for a full 12 days. Looking back on it, I am reminded of man's search for meaning. There was a quote used in reference to the shockingly stable mental states of most prisoners that I thought applied to me and my crew when we were out in the backcountry. Man is a creature that can get accustomed to anything. Of course, Philmont is nothing like concentration camps. For one, I actually want to go back to Philmont. the same does not apply to Auschwitz. Even though, I bet you're surprised that the person who knows so much about technology and ordinarily uses it on a daily basis had no problem living in the woods for a week and a half without any plumbing or flushing toilets. I know I was. Maybe I shouldn't have been, considering the survey that I'd conducted had a variety of different responses about my talents. What's interesting about those responses is that I agree with them all. This ability of mine to adapt to so many different environments and situations is probably one of the most defining features about myself.
I believe that while my interest in technology, my sense of humor, and my pastime of camping are more present in my life than my adaptability, all four of these traits provide a clear look into my meaning in life. A person deserves to do what they like to do in life. My homebrewed Wii and custom-built computer are proof of my belief in that. However, one thing that's just as important as that is to not be afraid to step outside your comfort zone. Like I've said, I've demonstrated that in nearly every environment you throw me into, I always find a way to enjoy it. The best advice I can give someone who's considering trying something completely new, like moving to a different country, is to go for it. In a short amount of time, you won't feel like your conditions have ever changed, and you'll probably now be better off than you were before. Well, when you look at that, my purpose in life has returned to me. I guess, now that I've realized where I find my meaning in life, I can finally go grab a snack, knowing that I'll choose the one that'll help me fulfill that purpose. This is gonna be harder than I thought.